Hello everyone, welcome to Art Calling and I am Tripurari Jha, and in this video I am going to show you how to make a natural color, and that's why I am here in this mango farm, set up all my things here, and I am going to share with you all the secrets of making a natural color. Usually I make natural color for Madhubani painting, but you can also use in other style of painting also. So in this part we are going to make three colors. First one is red, and red we can get from tree bark, that is a peepal tree. The second color that we make is yellow, and for yellow we are using turmeric. And this is our glue that we will going to use in while making a black color. And for making black color, we are using a fire byproduct, and that we get from the oil lamp. So now we are going to make a red color, and for that we are using a peepal tree bark, or it is also known as Bodhi tree. So here I am cutting the outer harder skin of the peepal tree, and to get a few ml of pigment we need lots of bark. Now we will gonna boil it for at least 20 to 25 minutes and make sure that water level should be of the bark. You can also boil it on a gas stove, and let's wait till it gets boiled. Now you can see it's already boiled, and we will remove all the barks from it, and in last you will gonna see the red pigment. Now we will boil it once again to get a desired consistency and the shade. The more you will boil, the more darker shade you will get. So now we will gonna filter our pigment to remove all the small fibers from the pigment. And for that we are using the cotton cloth, or you can also use the muslin cloth. While filtering, make sure to squeeze the cloth so there will be no wastage of pigment. You can see the long lasting red pigment, and we will gonna test it later on. So now we are going to make a yellow color, and for that we are using turmeric. And first we will need a paste of it, and after that we will get a pigment from this turmeric. So making a paste, we need to soak turmeric finger in water for at least 20 to 30 minutes, and after that we will grind it. Here I am using the traditional grinder, but you can also use the modern grinder as well. As while grinding, first we need to break into small pieces and add bit of water. As you can see that right now I'm adding a bit of water, and after that we will grind it till it gets the paste like consistency. Paste is ready, and now we will gonna put into the cotton cloth. We will gonna mix it with a few drops of water. Drain out our pigment by squeezing the cloth. The more you will squeeze, the more pigment you will get. Thank you. While creating a yellow color, my hands also became yellow. So now we are going to make a black color, and for that we are using the improvised lamp that we made few days back, and also using this metal spoon. First we will light up the lamp. We'll put our ladle bit above of oil lamp for at least half an hour to 1 hour. The more longer duration you will keep above the lamp, the more smoke you will able to collect. Though I will recommend you to place ladle on any stand, and otherwise you will feel a bit pain in your hand. Now we are going to prepare our natural gum by adding a bit of water and bit of Arabic gum. And place it for 20 or 30 minutes, and after that it will become a honey-like consistency, as you can see. We are going to pour our smoke that we collected from oil lamp by scratching through any wood. Now I am adding a natural gum or a gum arabic solution that we prepared into our smoke. Mix it. The more you will mix, the more fine consistency you will get. And if you find it's very thick, then you can add bit more solution of arabic gum. Like black color, similarly you can also add natural gum solution in other color that we made. It makes it more permanent and long lasting on paper. Though all these natural color, I will advise it to make freshly when you need it, because you can't keep it for several months. Now it's time to test our pigment that we created. Guys, if you found this video interesting and helpful, then please like, share this video with your friends and subscribe to the channel for such original content. By the way, second part of how to make a natural color is coming soon. Stay tuned. Before ending this video, I want to thank my brothers and Arsha who worked intensively behind the camera.